Hello, I'm Graham and welcome to today's video. In this video I want to take a closer look at the improvements to the QX10 lens camera from Sony following the firmware upgrade to version 2. Version 2 adds two important features to the QX10 performance. The first is the upgrade in the HD video recording to become now full HD 1920x1080 from the original 1440x1080. The frame rate remains the same at 30 frames per second irrespective of the region, and the bit rate now appears to be 60 megabits per second from the original 12 megabits per second. The second enhancement is the facility to manually set the camera ISO. It gives manual settings of ISO 100, 200, 400 and 800 as well as the automatic setting. To apply this firmware upgrade to your camera, you need to download the file from the Sony website and then follow the detailed instructions on how to carry out this procedure. After the update, the only way that you'll know that the update has been successful is the fact that the camera will have the manual ISO facility. Once you've established connection between the lens camera and your smartphone, either using the NFC or direct connection, you launch the Sony Play Memories application. And this is the interface it brings up on your smartphone. If I quickly take you around that interface to show you some of the features, left hand side we have the mode icon, and that brings up the choice between the photo and video mode. Once you've selected the photo mode, you can set the mode that you want the camera to work in, and you've got a choice of three. We've got the intelligent auto, which has the usual intelligent auto symbol, and the camera will just use scene detection to work out what the exposure should be. If you switch over to the superior auto mode, in some circumstances the camera will make multiple exposures and combine those to one to give you extended dynamic range. The program auto mode again is fully automatic, however in this facility you do get the option to change exposure value compensation should you find that the camera isn't responding to the scene the way that you want it to take. New with version 2 software is now the facility to change the ISO. You have a choice of leaving it in fully auto or a manual setting of 100, 200, 400 or 800. So obviously with this Series 2 firmware upgrade, the ability to lock the ISO down to any particular value is great. It means that you can set the ISO to 100 and get the best possible images out of the camera with best resolution and little noise. You can control the zoom by the touchscreen interface. So if you want to use telephoto zoom, then you can use it from the touchscreen. Or it's far easier if you've got the lens camera attached to your smartphone to use the rocker switch on the side of the camera to initiate your zoom, as it's much quicker. There is a lag between what the camera is recording and what the screen is displaying. That's an unfortunate occurrence when you're usually trying to send so much data over a Wi-Fi application. The camera has this touch to focus operation, so wherever you touch on screen the camera will focus and confirm by changing the icon to green, and the focus is fairly instantaneous. It's very quick on focus. It would be nice if the application had touch to shoot as well as touch to focus, as it does mean that once you've set the focus you then have to go over to the shutter release to actually take the picture. On the top of the display here, it gives you the number of images left on your mini SD card in the lens camera and the current format and image size that you've got set on the lens camera. Here on the screen is the arrow, and if you want to get rid of all the icons on the screen, if you just press that, it clears up the screen, just leaves you with the shutter button. Of course, if you want to see all the other displays, just click it back. The setup menu gives you access to some of the most common settings, such as the white balance. You can have an option of auto white balance, sunny, cloudy or tungsten, and for some reason three shades of fluorescent lighting. The self-timer mode, again, you've got the option of a 2 second or 10 second self-timer. You select 2 seconds, of course, when you press the shutter button. There's a 2 second delay before the camera fires. It isn't locked in, so if you want to use that again, you've got to go back into the menu and again set up the self-timer. The still image size depends on the actual aspect ratio you choose. So if you've chosen 4:3, you have the highest megapixel count of 18 or 5 in the 4:3 aspect ratio. If you're shooting in the same format as the video size, then you'll be using 16:9 aspect ratio, and you get the option to go 13 meg or 2 meg. The save options allow you to either save just the image to the lens camera or save it on your mobile phone as well. With this option, you can keep the full resolution file on the lens camera and transfer a 2 megabyte file across to your smartphone, or you have the option, as you'll see later in the menu, to transfer the full file size from the lens camera to your smartphone. Review the image, it will either be there for 2 seconds or you can leave it on indefinitely until you close it. The size of the review image, as I've just mentioned, can either have a 2 megabyte file or the original file size. If you select original, it will obviously depend on the aspect ratio and image size that you've selected as to how long it will actually take to bring the image across. So between 4 and 5 seconds for the 16:9 full resolution file. Where you've seen previously, if you select the 2 megabyte file, the camera can transfer that file over quite quickly. You have the option to turn off the beeps from the device when you connect the camera or take pictures, and you can also format the mini SD card in the lens camera from the application. The video mode is fully automatic. There is nothing you can change within the setup apart from the zoom. The new software gives you full 1920 by 1080 HD now at 30 frames per second, and that's at about 16 megabits per second bit rate. Previously it was 1440 by 1080, which was reminiscent of the old Blu-ray format. So they've upped the specification to give you full HD for playback on your mobile device or your televisions. In the movie mode, it's very much scene dependent. As you can see here, it's now selected the distant landscape icon. There's also an indication of whether you're on a tripod or using handheld, as image stabilization is used if you're using this device handheld. To start and stop recording, obviously, you just need to press the record button. When you are recording video, the video is only kept on the mini SD card in the camera. It isn't saved in the smartphone.
The images for this camera are really superb. Whether you're taking close-ups or distance shots, the clarity of the images is very good. Resolution is quite high, and the saturation and contrast of the images is also very good. There's no facility to change the colour space that you're working with or any of the parameters for the colour capture, but the default seems to be quite good. Well, that's it for this short video. Thanks very much for watching. If you are a new viewer to the channel, please consider clicking the subscribe button, as if I upload any new videos, they'll appear in your subscription list when you view it. So until my next video, thanks again for watching, take care, and bye for now.